Who are your beta testers? Let's find out. Beta testing is an important phase of the product development, where a group of users tries a product before its official release. But who these beta testers actually are? Should you care? We believe you definitely should. Beta testing is practically ubiquitous, everywhere from car industry through medicine to software development. Participants test and troubleshoot products to help improve their functioning and avoid defects. For successful beta testing, the population of testers must be as similar to the final customers as possible. If this is not the case, the results of beta testing can be heavily biased and might fail to capture important product flaws. This research presents the case study results of a large comparison between 80,000 beta testers and 500,000 standard users of an endpoint security software. Throughout, we focused on technological aspects, demographics, and perceived computer skills. For this particular software, beta testers were more likely to be young, male, and there is a higher probability of them being IT technicians. They tend to perceive themselves as more skilled with computers and are early adopters of newer operating systems. This supports the popular belief that beta testers are the computer geeks. However, we found their hardware to be very similar to that of standard users, which slightly contradicts this accepted image. A striking difference was found in the countries of origin. Beta testers most often came from Mexico, Indonesia, and Brazil. Speaking of general trends, they dominated in South America and Europe. Standard users, on the other hand, most often came from Iran, the US, and India. They were more often based in Asia, Africa, and Australia. These differences are specific to the analyzed software, but they illustrate a possible contrast between beta testers and standard users. Overall, beta testers represented the population of standard users reasonably well. There was no type of standard users that would be largely underrepresented in the sample of beta testers. For large or international companies who are able to attract large numbers of beta testers, just taking everyone available and analyzing the differences could be the most efficient approach. However, for smaller, local, or not so well-established companies, this approach would probably not yield representative outcomes and may even shift the development focus in the wrong direction. For smaller companies, this is therefore not a viable option. So, what do we advise you to do? 1. Use the data you are able to collect to find out who your users and beta testers are. Consider the country of origin, software and hardware configuration, and basic demographics. 2. The fewer testers you have, the pickier you should be about their selection. Make sure you cover all relevant types of standard users. 3. When testing international products, ensure your beta testers are culturally representative of standard users to identify localization and cultural usability issues. In short, take interest in who your beta testers are. This work was created at Masaryk University in cooperation with ASSET, an international software security company. It was published in Communications of the ACM in 2018.